Hello Internet and welcome to CodePick. In this video, we will be going through what is digital forensics, a brief history of digital forensics methods, operating system and open source tools used by experts in the industry, commercial tools used by experts, and finally, what are the threats to digital forensics. So, by the end of this video, you can get to know if you want to take up digital forensics as a professional job, and if so, what are the things you need to keep in mind and what are the tools you need to master. I hope I got you excited, so let's get started. Welcome back guys. So, without wasting any time, let me start off with the definition of digital forensics. Digital forensics is a branch of forensic science encompassing preservation, acquisition, documentation, analysis, and interpretation of evidence identified from various storage types. Let me just remind you, digital forensics is not only limited to data in your laptop, desktop, or mobile device. It may as well include data transmitted over public and private networks. Cool. Now that you know the definition of digital forensics, which in itself is pretty much self-explanatory, let's take a look at what a digital forensic expert actually does in real life. The first being data recovery. Although it does not sound super cool, it is one of the most important and crucial skills a digital forensic expert needs to master. So, data recovery in simple includes investigating and recovering deleted files, a file that has changed into a different file extension, or a file hidden for some reason. Although it sounds like a simple task, evaluating a suspect device and recovering data in such a manner as to not tamper with the existing data on the suspect device take a lot of time and patience. Also, following a series of steps and documenting those steps so that they can be reproduced at the court of law or in front of the necessary authorities is a skill in itself. The next basic task of a digital forensic investigation is identity theft. In this digital world where our data is being sold for less than a price of Pringles, identity theft are way too common. It is the job of digital forensic expert to keep a track on these thefts and bring the ones responsible to justice. Although it sounds very cool, it takes up a lot of man hours and documentation to prove someone guilty of identity theft. If we are dealing with someone who is a pro in this job, then the time may go from weeks to months. The next task on our hand is malware and ransomware investigation. This is where the actual fun starts. Private organizations have seen a surge in the number of malware and ransomware attacks that are being carried out against an entire organization or an individual of that organization. It is your job as a professional to find and eliminate threat before bringing down an entire organization. It is one of the most money-rewarding jobs currently in the market. Although, I will be teaching you how to find, remove and document malware and ransomware in lab condition, I just want to tell you in the real world, most of the malware or ransomware will be highly targeted and not generic. Next we have network and internet investigation. This includes investigating denial of service attacks and distributed denial of service attacks. As I will be demonstrating in the further videos as to how easily we can investigate these attacks thanks to the development and the open source tools which make our lives a lot easier these investigations. Finally, we have email investigation and corporate espionage, which are extremely money rewarding fields. This involves investigating business email compromises and removing any digital footprints which are left behind by an organization. Since all companies are moving their data from hard copies to the cloud, there may be digital footprints left behind which can be used against them if not figured out and resolved quickly. Now that you know what exactly will be your job as a digital forensic expert, let's take a brief history to get to know more about how it all started. The year is 1980 and the personal computer was introduced to the world, which gained so much popularity that one organization was very much interested in the boom of personal computers, the FBI. In the year 1984, the FBI set up the world's first digital forensics lab, which was led by the FBI's Specialized Computer Analysis and Response Team. But digital forensics as its own field grew substantially in the year 1990 with the collaboration of several law agencies and head of division working together and even meeting up regularly to bring their expertise on the table. One of the earliest formal conferences was hosted by the FBI in the year 1993. The event was called International Law Enforcement Conference on Computer Evidence, which was to address the need for formal standards and procedures with digital forensics and evidence acquisition. Many of these conferences resulted in the formation of independent bodies to govern and standard the best practice for digital forensics. With advancement in technology, the tools for digital forensics must be regularly updated, not only in the fight against cybercrime, but in the ability to provide accountability and for the retrieval of lost data. I would urge you to go through the links in the description below to get to know more about the current standards in the industry. Now that you know a brief history of digital forensics, let's quickly look at some of the open source tools available at our disposal which are used by professionals around the world. So, the first open source tool we will be looking at is the Digital Evidence and Forensics Toolkit. The best thing about DEFT is it runs live on the host machine and let us perform mobile forensics, network forensics, password recovery, and much more without tampering with the existing data on the host machine. Using DEFT, you can easily document the series of steps and recreate those steps at any point of time and produce the same result as you are now, in no way tampering with the host data. The next tool which we'll be looking at is Computer-Aided Investigation Environment. Kane is pretty similar to DEFT, but the place where Kane shines is with the feature it offers called Unblock feature. Enabling this feature prevents us from writing data directly onto the host machine. This gives us much more control over whether we want to write data or not. This offers its own benefits, which we will look into later on. Last but not the least, we will be looking into Kali Linux. I mean, I don't need to explain to you much about it. You might have already encountered it at some point if you have been interested in digital forensics. As you know, Kali Linux provides you with all the possible tools out of the box that you can imagine, and the best part is it's open source and it's free to use. If you master Kali Linux, the limit of what you can do is limitless. Don't worry, if you don't know Kali Linux or any of its features, consider subscribing, because in my future videos I will make sure to teach you the basics of using most of the tools in Kali Linux in lab condition. Now that you know some of the popular open source choices for digital forensics used by professionals, let me quickly get you through some of the commercial tools out there. Just a quick note, some of these tools actually cost a lot of money and some are subscription based. I won't be demonstrating any of these tools, but you can just download the trial version and check if they solve your needs. From my personal experience, you won't be needing most of these commercial tools on a day-to-day basis. With that said, let's take a look at the first tool, Belcasoft Evidence Center 2020. This is an automated evidence response and forensic tool that is capable of analyzing acquired images of memory dumps, virtual machine, mobile, and cloud backup data. Belcasoft are kind enough to offer their acquisition tool and RAM capture tool for free. You can get them by heading over to the links in the description below. The next tool is Access Data Forensic Toolkit. This has been used by professional and law enforcement agencies for a long time and it offers the same perks as Belcasoft. Also, Belcasoft and FKT have joined hands to improve their platform and offer better UI and tooling. Finally, we will take a look at Encase. Encase has been at the forefront for many years and have been used by professionals internationally and worldwide. They offer pretty much the same tooling as FKT. You can check out the tooling by heading over to the official website. You can find the link to it in the description below. Now that you know the tools that are being used, I want to finish this video by letting you know some of the threats to digital forensics, so you can make a better decision on whether or not to choose it as a professional career. The first threat being the growth of the use of VPN. This is because most of the VPN provider never keep the logs of their users and their activity for more than 7 days, and a cleverly designed malware or a ransomware may go undetected for several weeks together. So, backtracking the source of the attack can get really tricky and sometimes be impossible. The second threat is the advancement and encryption standard. As you already know, the encryption standards and the algorithm used for encryption have improved a lot over the recent years. With some encryption tools like TrueCrypt and BitLocker offering multiple layers of encryption, it makes our life a lot harder to crack open a device that is highly encrypted. Because most of these software will pipe all the data after multiple wrong tries, making our lives a lot harder. The final threat the digital forensic world is currently facing is online and offline anonymity. With many tools that offer MAC and IP masking, it is very difficult to pinpoint a device that caused the attack and find the real culprit. Tools like Tor browser that offers you anonymity on the internet are the same tools used by the culprits to access the dark web and carry out attacks. Although we can pinpoint the source of the attack, it would take a lot of time and man hours. With that said, I have given you a complete overview of what you should know when you start your journey as a digital forensic expert. This is the end of the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If so, drop a like and subscribe. See you in the next video. Happy coding until then.